Hey everyone, Chell here with Prismatic Powders, and today we're going to talk about why balancing your powder air control is crucial for dialing in your powder cloud. We'll also show you how to do it. A quick disclaimer though, I'll be using some general terms for the settings that we'll be adjusting. But keep in mind that terminology may vary depending on the manufacturer of your spray gun. So let's get started. Now, balancing your airflow through the gun is critical, and it's not only key for efficient powder application, but it's also essential for achieving consistent, high-quality results. Unbalanced settings can lead to two main issues. You'll have a lean cloud, which is too much air compared to powder, which creates a weak application, or a rich cloud, that's too much powder and not enough air, and that's gonna cause uneven buildup and poor coverage because you're gonna have surging. Neither condition is ideal. What you're aiming for is an even, consistent powder cloud, not too lean, not too rich. But here's the thing, there is no one-size-fits-all setting. You'll need to tweak your settings based upon the parts that you're coating and the powder that you're using, because some powders are denser and require a different air to powder ratio. Now, to do this, you need to understand your controls. Most professional and even high-end prosumer powder coating guns let you adjust your air velocity, which controls the speed at which powder is carried through the system and out the gun. And then there's powder atomization, which controls how much powder is mixed with the air and sprayed. Changes to either setting will dramatically affect your powder cloud. Let's take a look at what I call a lean powder cloud. In this case, there's too much air velocity compared with the amount of powder. And as you can see, the cloud looks light and sparse. This won't build well on the part at all. Now, let's look at a powder cloud that's too rich. You can see the surging and how uneven the powder distribution is. So how do you set your powder cloud to work best for your application? Well, first you need to ask, what am I coating? A large flat panel versus tight corners are going to require different settings. And if you're not familiar with the numeric settings on your system, here's a little tip. As a general rule, you want more powder than air. But keep in mind, for general applications, your spray range is typically 8 to 12 inches from the part, but it does vary based upon the part, so be sure that your settings will work within the distance that you'll be spraying from. Now here's how I usually set things up for flat surfaces. Start with powder atomization. On this Nordson Encore VT, powder is at 14 and air velocity is at 9. I observe the cloud from 8 to 12 inches away, and then I evaluate if I need more powder for the parts. If I need to add more powder, I'll also need to add more air. Gradually add air velocity until the cloud flows evenly with no surging. I'll add in increments of 2 until I get it right. Now we're ready to spray. When you're coating tight areas, too much air velocity can be a problem. It'll blow the powder right out of the corners. So here's what to do. You need to start by lowering your air velocity, and then you can adjust your powder atomization to maintain a proper cloud. All right, hopefully this highlights why dialing in your powder cloud is so important. It's not just about getting powder on the part, it's about making smart adjustments based upon the parts that you're coating and the powders that you're using. So thanks so much for watching this, and then we'll see you in the next one.